I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Come see me. I'm about that. Big trust. Woo woo. Lamar Jackson in the flesh.
Big trust.
Best team in the state of Washington. Big trust.
This is how we do it.
Fun.
And you get to meet new people.
Yeah.
We're all sisters because we're really close.
Yeah. It's what we love.
True.
Yeah.
The relationships I've created with the girls on the team. Learning new dances too.
I like the people.
Meeting people.
Yeah.
In the morning.
Very early in the morning.
5:25 in the morning.
We got better from the beginning of like when we went to camp.
Dancing in and then kick, and this is our first year doing kick, and I'm really surprised on where we're all at right now.
I got my turns back after a lot of years.
I learned how to do the splits.
I got my triple.
I learned how to dance.
I got my front aerial.
Oh, you got it.
Then lost it.
All year. Pretty much. It ends in March, and then tryouts are like a month
March.
Later.
Yeah.
Or like,
wait, what'd you just say?
What's your favorite dance move?
Hip hop. Hip hop, hands down.
I do like kick if it was clean.
I like dance.
What was your favorite routine?
The jazz one? Yeah, I like that one too.
Oh, yeah.
Like, yeah, Chips and Dutch Bros and all that stuff, but you still have to stay in some kind of shape. You need to eat a little bit more healthier. Everybody is a leader in their own way.
Like, when you're on the dance team, you're already supposed to be a leader. Like, you're supposed to be encouraging your team, and then so giving the title to the captain, you just have more responsibility, and it's more like you need to be doing it for the other girls.
Mr. Blake. Mr. Clayton. Miss Glenn. Miss Schwilke.
Perfect.
Yeah, what's up?
Should I go to Sadie's?
Yeah, why wouldn't you?
Because I don't know who to ask, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but there's lots of cool guys in our class. I'm sure one of them would go with you.
I guess you're right.
This isn't sticking, let's go back to class.
Okay.
Thanks, G. Hey, what about Mikhail?
I could totally ask him.
He's so cool.
Yeah, he has a butcher swag.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, 100%. Okay, I'm at the tape. Let's go.
Okay.
Can you help me make the poster?
Yeah, for sure. Let's just look at Pinterest.
Okay.
Sweet.
Dang, there's him. Look at all that swag he has.
Oh my gosh, he's so cool.
I know. That one's cute. It matches so perfect with the swag. That one's it.
Good.
Okay.
Nah.
The Chiawana Core Department presents you with A Sweet Night for Jazz, Wednesday, January 29th, Chiawana High School stage at 7 p.m. Tickets are $10 at the door, but if you ask a vocal jazz member, $7 for pre-sale, they'll mark you down. It's gonna be a night of delicious treats and jazz solos performed by Chiawana High School Vocal Jazz, including me, yours truly, Makai. Desserts will be included with the purchase of your ticket. Get yourself a cupcake or something. And if you need any more information, contact Mrs. Glenn's email address right here.
My name is Mrs. Jarvis. I'm a teacher here at Chiawana High School. I teach in the 9th grade STEM program and I teach literacy intervention. So something that would probably surprise students about me would be my reasons for going into teaching. A lot of times teachers will talk about their reason for going into education is because they had really good experiences as a student and wanted to be a teacher. While I did have some really amazing teachers in my youth, I had some challenges with some of my teachers, and I wanted to become a teacher so that I could be a good role model for students and to be available for them, somebody that they could go to in their life that was safe and that would help them in whatever way they needed. If I could pass on any wisdom to my students, I would probably tell them to enjoy being a kid as long as they can, because you will spend more of your life as an adult than as a kid, and you'll probably spend most of your time as an adult wishing you were a kid again. Definitely would be Disneyland. Disneyland is my favorite place to be, and in my STEM program, we talk a lot about creative and engineering design processes. And Disneyland does some really amazing things with their engineers. In fact, they call them Imagineers. And so they combine the engineering and scientific principles of the building of the parks and of the rides, along with this very creative storytelling. And being an English teacher myself, fusing those two together, I think is a really cool thing. So I would love to take them to go and see that in practice. Plus, Disneyland's just a pretty place, fun place to go.